Alright, welcome to another video, and before we get started, I'd like to take a quick minute to thank all the Patreon supporters and YouTube channel members whose names you see scrolling across the screen right now. They make this financially possible, and without you, I probably wouldn't be here making videos, so thank you. Alright, so welcome back to another FPV video with the Swordfish, running walk snail. So for today's flight, we are testing some more changes to
fly-by-wire A.
The autopilot tuning, still trying to work out that little bit of sway on the yaw axis that we have while in heading hold modes. And I'm not sure how smooth the air is today, so I'm going to fly a little bit in fly-by-wire just for a second here, just to get a feel for it. You see we do have a little bit of turbulence, it is a little bit rough. We still have the sun not really set yet. We probably still have a little bit of that daytime heating out here on the freshly plowed fields, and in contrast to the cooler green areas around it, we generally do get some turbulent air, some thermal activity out here. But I think it's good enough to be able to see if it's going to track straight or not. So I'm going to go ahead and put the airplane on a heading right out toward the corner of the field right out there, or the woods on the far side of the next two fields, and we're going to go to cruise. Now I'm not going to touch the sticks, just going to fly in cruise and see if it tracks straight or if it starts that little swaying on the yaw axis. So far it looks good, it is struggling a little bit. Like I said, you can see it's kind of nosing up and down as it attempts to hold altitude with some of the thermal lift and everything, which that should calm down a little bit once we get out over this greener area. At least I think so. But so far I haven't noticed any of that distinct left and right wag on the nose. There's a little bit of roll left and right here, but it's seemingly more random rather than a steady kind of left right oscillation. And I kind of did expect that because I do have a previous flight where I made some changes to some of the parameters related to the Nav L1 controller. Think is the right term for that, but I'll put the parameters on screen right now, the ones that I've changed and the values that I arrived at. And I did see some improvement. I made a small change on the previous flight and I saw some improvement, and after that I wanted to make a little bit more change in the same direction, just go a little bit further and see if it did improve, and to me it seems like it did. Now another thing that we want to check is I'm going to switch to return to home and just make sure that it handles a turn like that and that it doesn't tend to overshoot the turn or anything crazy like that. So let's go ahead and trigger that now. We'll go to return to launch. And it seems to be turning pretty decent in the turn, and I want to see how it handles this where it straightens out. Yeah, we definitely didn't overshoot there. If anything, it really looks kind of perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and let it fly back home and see how well it tracks. And once it gets home, it's going to circle home at approximately 200 feet altitude is what it's set up to do. And we'll also get to see not only how well it tracks on the way home, which it does seem to be doing a pretty good job right now. I do see a little bit of that kind of roll left and right, but I think it's more or less just holding this heading. It's just making little minor corrections to stay on the heading and not so much kind of overshooting and being too aggressive with it and kind of starting that little bit of oscillation left and right. So I'm pretty happy with the changes so far, and I think this is going to be able to pretty much pin it down and finalize my tune for this little airplane. And I may fine tune it over time as we go, as I learn more about this stuff. Because like I said, this is the first time I've actually tuned the navigation controller in Ardupilot. It's the first time I've needed to. Everything else I've flown with it, it handled it just fine. But like I said, this one having that somewhat unique, shallow, swept forward V-tail back there, I guess it kind of presents its own unique challenges, at least to some degree. But I kind of liked it. I took it as a learning experience, a challenge to learn more about Ardupilot and how to tune it when these little types of issues arise. And now we're smarter than we were before. So just kind of looking at the positive sides of it. But I'm pretty happy with the way it's flying right now. I'm curious how well it's going to turn or handle this turn coming up. You can see it's starting to lighter my safe home position. Or actually, it's a... I forget what they're called in Ardupilot. Safe home is a 9-nav term. Rally point. That's what they're called in Ardupilot. So I have a rally point set. I'm going to turn on my little GPS overlay. It's kind of small, but I guess if you're watching a full resolution, you can kind of see what I'm talking about there. You notice that first circle that was already on the map, that's where we took off and was loitering in takeoff mode at the end of the takeoff sequence. And the circle that it's on right now is centered around my rally point, which, like I've explained before, it puts it kind of where the plane's flying right now on the north end of this loiter. It keeps it out over the open area so that it doesn't end up into some of those trees and buildings around the house and things back there. That if it loitered my actual takeoff point, half of my loiter radius would be out over the bayou and the trees and sheds and things like that that could end poorly if the airplane ever ended up in a situation where it needed to loiter until the battery went dead and kind of land itself. So that's why I have this rally point set up out here. But you can see it's tracking really well. It's drawing a perfect circle on the map, and it's not, you know, straying from that circle. Every lap around it so far is right on top of the previous laps. So everything looks really good. I'm really happy with the way it's flying. So one other thing we can test is how well it climbs in a return to home situation. So I'm going to go back to fly by wire. And I guess we can actually go to cruise. As we are kind of trying to test the navigation enabled modes, which cruise is one. But yeah, I mean, you can see it is doing a little bit of kind of random slight banking left and right here and there as the gusts arise and kind of push it off course. But for the most part, it's just kind of sitting with the nose locked right on that point out on the horizon. Other than when the little gusts hit it here and there, it'll kind of correct for them. But I'm pretty happy with it. And once again, with that course lay, the GPS course up there, and in fact, I'm going to change the heading right now manually so that we don't overrun those previous courses that are plotted on the map. You can kind of see how well it's drawing straight lines on it. They're not kind of wavering around like they were when we still had the issue. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I think that was the cause of it and the proper way to fix it. And everything seems to be performing really well now. So like I said, I do want to try it, trigger and return to home from a lower altitude, and so that it's going to climb. Because right now it's set to return home at 200 feet. So if it's above 200 feet, it'll just slowly descend so that it reaches 200 feet when it gets home. But if it's below 200 feet, it's going to climb straight ahead to a certain point, and then it will turn and fly home at 200 feet. So I'm going to go to fly-by-wire and cut power and push the nose down. And we'll do a pass out toward the cows out here. And we're just going to get down here. I mean, not ridiculously low or anything, but we're going to get down here, lose some altitude, and get back into a nice little cruise. Right out here. See, we're starting to scare some of the birds up. Out there, there's one. Should be coming out behind the wing. There he is. And I see a few of them still down there by the cows. But we're not going to chase them around right now. That's not our prerogative. A lot of dust from the vehicle that just passed. So we're out over the open field right now. I'm actually going to point the nose this way. Hopefully it'll make a turn over the field. I'm just kind of curious if it will. I'm going to trigger return to launch right here.
Return to launch.
And yes, it is going to bank slightly to the left. But you see it's climbing for the most part with a shallow turn to the left. And then once it gets close to 200 feet, it'll make a sharper turn and get on course for home. See, once it hits that 200 feet, it settles down, tries to settle on 200 feet, and locks a heading for home and locks the altitude. It's actually sitting at like 195, 196. And I believe it's set pretty close to exactly 200 feet. You actually set it in, I think it's in centimeters, if I'm not mistaken. Is the value that you set, so it might not be exactly 200 feet, but it is set fairly close to it. But yeah, I mean, it navigates perfectly fine. I'm really happy with it. I don't see any issues, nothing to complain about. And I do believe it's performing better now than it has so far. So, I had posted a Ardupilot configuration, just basically a backup of my parameters previously, with some notes about some things that are going to be unique to everyone's setup that you kind of have to set up yourself. I did reset some of those things to default. But if you downloaded any, or if you downloaded that, then you know what all those parameters and everything are. You already know what I'm talking about. But if you downloaded that previous configuration, I'll go ahead and I'm going to update the one in the link, so that if you go back and watch that other video and you download from there, you can see the updated parameters as well. And I'll go ahead and post a link under this video also, because I do believe this is a more proper, better tuned setup than what I had shared previously. So it's probably worth posting an updated setup for those of you that are using it. And if you already have your plane flying well and you just want to know how to fix the left and right wagon navigation control modes, then like I said earlier in the video, you'll have seen the parameters on screen overlaid on top of the video, what changes I made to correct it. Now, one change that I did make, I had mentioned previously, I reduced the rudder mix, the roll to rudder mix in Ardupilot. I cut that in half. Default is 0.5. I had it drop down to 0.25, and it didn't really show any improvement, but it did seem that that was pretty close to what the mix value needed to be based on the testing that I did. So I'm going to leave that alone for now, and it's probably something I'll revisit in the future and see if I need to go back closer to 0.5 or just leave it where it's at now. But I guess if I do change anything like that, that's going to make it fly better or different or anything like that, I'll probably go ahead and do another updated configuration for that. But right now I'm pretty happy with it. And I'm probably just going to fly it and enjoy it and stop messing with it. So like I said, I am pretty happy with the way it flies right now, and everything looks perfectly fine. Totally acceptable, and I really don't see anything to improve on. So, yeah. I guess that's going to be the end of this video. I'm going to go ahead and end this one to keep it relatively short. It'll be end up being about a 15-ish minute video, looking at my flight timer. But yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and fly some more of this battery out. And like I said, we have plenty of time before the sun sets. And we have plenty of battery left, and opportunity presents itself, so I'm going to go ahead and take advantage of it and fly and enjoy the airplane. But I'm going to end this video now just to keep a little bit short and maybe retain your attention a little bit better. But just kind of keep it so it doesn't get long and boring and you click away. But yeah, I guess if anything exciting happens, I'll post it in a separate video. But if not, then I guess next time I have something to post, I'll post that instead. So thank you for watching this video, and hopefully this has been informative and enjoyable and useful to you, to those of you that asked for the Ardupilot configuration. Like I said, I did want to take the time to figure out how to tune this one without modifying the airplane itself. I knew it could be done. I just had to learn how to do it. And like I said, we're smarter now than we were before, so we benefit from it. And hopefully everyone wins. So thank you for watching this video, and I will see you all in the next ones.